What's up, guys? It's Brian, back again. This time, this piece is actually, I'm really proud of, because this is the first painting that I've done that wasn't following along with someone else's tutorial on YouTube. And, you know, I've been able to learn a lot just going on YouTube and finding different tutorials for watercolor paintings and acrylic paintings. But I wanted to challenge myself to do something that wasn't following along with someone else. So this is a skull painting that I did that started just as a regular pencil sketch. And I felt confident with my ability to kind of get the shape down and get some of the details and the shading. So I wanted to try it as a painting. So what you're seeing here is just the beginnings of this, blocking in the black background. And you see my pencil sketch of the actual skull on the canvas. And now I'm going over just with some light, kind of bone, white, off-white bone shades of colors, and then blocking in the really dark shaded areas of the eye sockets. And then there were also, with the reference photo, these two or three flowers that were just framing the skull on the right and left side, as well as a flower in the right eye socket. And so I'm going here and just starting to fill in some of the basic colors behind the flowers. And again, like, the big thing I'm learning as I'm learning more about painting as I go through these processes and I'm trying just different things is the amount of patience it takes. And this is a painting that I worked on over probably 2 or 3 days, doing, you know, a layer here, a layer there, waiting for it to dry, taking my time with it. And eventually I'm sure I'll get to a place where I can do this type of work much faster and in a more efficient way. And I can already tell just by watching this video and watching some of the choices I made color-wise, where I made the process actually more complicated than it necessarily needed to be, just because I had to spend a lot of time mixing colors and then remixing colors and not getting the shade right. Like, one of the things I didn't get to where I would have liked it was the violet color of the flower that's in the right eye socket of the skull. In the reference photo, there's light that's catching the flower, and it's much lighter and more almost like a fluorescent violet purple, and it was very hard for me to mix that color just with the primary colors that I had on my palette, which was, you know, I had a couple shades of red, a couple shades of blue, and then white, and trying to get that violet with those shades of colors was near impossible. So if there's one part of this painting that I'm not totally thrilled with the most, it's probably just the color of that flower in the eye socket. But just like anything with art, you just got to keep rolling with it and just keep working it and keep making little adjustments here and there and re-going over areas. And that's one of the forgiving things about painting in acrylics, is you can layer and layer and layer and layer and layer. So if you mess up a color, if you mess up a detail, you can go and correct it. Whereas with watercolor, it's harder to do that because watercolors are more translucent, I guess, and see-through. So when they set on the canvas, it's like it's very hard to totally cover up a certain area. So here you see, you know, in front of the skull, there's some petals that look like they're from the same flower that are in the right eye socket, and I'm trying to get the color right on them here and just having a difficult time with it. So I decided to wait and go from those petals to just blocking in the rest of the background, since that's just black, and I figured if I could get the background a little more close to where it was in the reference, it'd give me a better time of trying to get the shading right on the skull and the lighting right in the rest of the painting. So I'm just kind of going through that here, and I'm really happy with how this painting turned out. You'll see the finished product at the end of this video, but just really enjoying learning it as I go and getting a little bit better with everything that I make. And I'm excited to have some original pieces of my artwork hanging in our apartment, which is really cool. So just having a blast with it and just trying to keep exploring and trying different mediums and just trying a little bit of everything right now. So at this point, it's dried overnight. This is the second day that I'm working on it. So I'm coming here and trying to fill in a little bit more of the details on the teeth, The teeth were challenging on this skull because a couple of the teeth were missing, a couple of the teeth were rotting away, and the shading on the teeth, because of the way the light in the reference is hitting the skull, was challenging to get those colors blended. And I think I could have done a little bit of a better job there, but you'll see as I keep going through. I'm spending a lot of time on the upper left part of the skull because that's where a lot of the shading is, and it really does, in the reference, fade out into the background. So there's a very, very faint outline on the skull in the reference photo, and that was really hard to try to recreate with paint, because if I went in with a predominantly black color and tried to blend in the outline of the skull, it almost made the skull look smaller than it needed to be, because the black was just blacking out the outline so much that you just lose the shape of the skull a little bit. So I had to go back over that part and keep blending a darker and darker brown so I could get it as smooth as I could. So it took a lot of just waiting for it to dry and going back over the same parts over and over again. Same thing with a lot of the little imperfections in the bone of the skull and how the light hits those. It took a lot of experimenting to try to get that to the point where I felt comfortable with the finished product. And as with any piece of art, there's definitely a lot of parts of this that I can recognize that I could have done a better job with. But it's one of those things, especially when you're painting something like this, where it gets to the point where you realize, okay, I can keep reworking this part of the painting, this line, this piece of shading, but it's not going to get any better. If anything, it might actually start getting worse, because you start going over the same parts over and over again, details get muddy, you lose certain details, and then you have to try to rework them and get them back. So there comes a point with, I think, any painting and any piece where you just get to the point where you're like, as satisfied with it as you're gonna be. And I think a lot of that just comes from my inexperience too. I think over time I'll learn to be able to go in and keep reworking finer details, kind of in the way I'm doing here. I'm going in with some white now and trying to re-white out certain areas that I darkened too much to try to get it to match the reference photo a little bit more, trying to lose some of this hard outline I had in the eye socket on the left eye and make that fade a little bit smoother. So that's kind of what I'm doing here. But I'm going to keep putting out these videos. I got some ideas of some pieces that I want to do coming up, more landscape pieces. I bought a bunch of small canvases like this one from an art supply store up here in New York, so I'm going to do some experimentation with those. And if you guys have any suggestions, more experienced artists out there, more experienced painters of different subject matter that you found really helps you in your journey as far as your skill level and skill sets are concerned, whether it's painting from still life, whether it's painting landscape architecture stuff, whether it's drawing more subject matter. I mean, one of the biggest tips that I've gotten and that I've taken to heart so far just from more experienced artists is realizing that the more I can draw from actual life, so not even using a reference photo, but actual things that are physically in my environment, the better I'll get at being able to translate shapes and kind of the energy behind objects and poses down onto paper. So I've tried to do that more. I want to spend a little bit of time this week going to, you know, a coffee shop that I like, for instance, and just trying to draw the people around me or draw the environment. So I want to challenge myself to do that a little bit more this week rather than just draw still life from a reference photo. But I think there's value in both, obviously. And I think ultimately I'm trying to just keep it simple with this, with like my art training or my philosophy around training to be an artist is I just want to make it more about the effort. So like the more time I can spend drawing, the more drawings I can do, the more paintings I can do, regardless of what the point or the philosophy is behind each piece, the better I'm ultimately going to get. So I think it's just part of it, a huge part of it is just getting your 10,000 hours. So that's what I'm focusing on moving forward. And any suggestions you guys have, if there's more experienced artists out there watching this and you're seeing rookie mistakes that I'm making, or maybe something that you used to do that you're seeing me do that you think I could correct and make the finished product better, I'm definitely open to hearing about it. And just really enjoying kind of getting myself to a place in my mind where I'm focused on being an artist and focused on being a beginner and focused on being a student. And I think that's helping every other area of my life, because the more you can approach your life with like a beginner's mindset, the more possible it is for you to have new insights and new ideas and new innovations to the way you live your life and just your overall happiness and fulfillment in what you're doing. So here's the finished product. I'm excited by how it came out. I'm happy with where it is, especially for my first painting of doing something without a tutorial that's just based on my own interpretation of a reference photo. So hope you guys like it. Stay tuned for more, and talk to you guys soon. Peace.